Yes, in this video, we'll be considering this question. Solve for s in this equation, 3 raised to the power of 2s plus 1 minus 4 into 3 raised to the power of s plus 1 equals to 0. Yeah, solution. This is indices leading to what? Quadratic equation. So this is the question. 3 raised to the power of 2s plus 1 minus 4 into 3 raised to the power of s plus 1 equals to 0. So don't forget, in my previous video, I've taught us how to break this down. So you have to break it down. So this will be, let me just show you. So for us to have 3 raised to the power of 2s plus 1, it means that we are having 3 raised to the power of 2s multiplied by 3 raised to the power of 1. Because of the laws of indices, the product to, for us to have this back, this will be equal to, we just pick one of the base 3, then you add the power to get that. I hope you don't forget this. So I'll be breaking down this as 3 raised to the power of 2s multiplied by 3 raised to the power of 1 and minus 4 into 3 raised to the power of s plus 1 equals to what? Equals to 0. So from here, look at 3 raised to the power of 2s. I'll break it down again. This one can be written as 3 raised to the power of s raised to the power of 2 multiplied by 3 raised to the power of 1, which is what? 3. Which is 3. So I can close the bracket. Minus 4 into 3 raised to the power of s minus 4 into 3 raised to the power of s plus 1 equals to 0. So we have 3 raised to the power of s here, 3 raised to the power of s here. I'll just say let 3 raised to the power of s equals to p. I love letter p because it means promotion, progress. So here, I'll just substitute p for 3 raised to the power of s in the above equation. So this one will be p raised to the power of 2, then this one multiplied by 3 minus 4, sorry, 4 minus 4 into minus 4 into p plus 1 equals to 0. So don't forget, this will be p squared. 3 times the p raised to the power of 2 is p squared. 3 times p squared is 3p squared minus 4p plus 1 equals to 0. So I'll be considering factorization method here. 3 times 1 is 3. So I'll be looking for two numbers that I can multiply together that will give me 3. And when I add the number together, that will give me minus 4. So what are the two numbers? But multiply, if I choose 3 and 1, 3. If I choose 3 and 1, if I choose 3 and 1, 3 times 1 will give me 3. That is correct. 3 plus 1 will give me 4. But this is minus 4. It means that is not correct. But if I'm having minus 3 and minus 1, minus 3 times 1 will give me 3. Minus 3 plus minus 1 will give me minus 4. Show that this is correct. So I'll be making use of that. 3p squared minus 3p minus p. Don't forget, minus 1 is still the same as minus 1p, which is still what? Minus p plus 1 equals to what? 0. So for me, I'll be considering those parts, these two parts. 3 is common, p is common. So I'll factor that out. 3p is common. So here, I'll be left with p minus 1. So here, what is common here is just minus 1. Minus 1 into, don't forget that we left with p minus 1. What is here must be equal to what is here, as I've told us in my earlier video, and I've explained some facts here. So I will have to factorize now. Factorize this and this, and I'll pick one of these. So this will be 3p minus 1 into p minus 1. So don't forget that everything is equal to 0. This is equal to 0. So here I'll be saying that either either this is equals to 0 or this is equals to 0. 3p minus 1 is equals to 0 or p minus 1 is equals to 0. So here, for me to get p here, 3p will be equals to 1 and p will be equals to 1 all over 3 or p will be equals to 1. So p is equals to 1 all over 3 or 1. But don't forget, the question says we should solve for s, not p. So for us to get s here, don't forget I've already said let 3 raised to the power of s equals to what? P. So I'll say but 3 raised to the power of s is equals to p. So when p is equals to 1 all over 3, let me talk for 1 all over 3 first, because we have two values for p. So 3 all over s will be equals to 1 all over 3. And don't forget that 3 raised to the power of s will be equals to 1 all over, it's just minus. And here it will be minus 1, 3 raised to the power of minus 1. So here, 3 will neutralize 3, then we'll be left with s to be equals to minus 1. So when p is equals to 1 now, when p is equals to 1, 3 raised to the power of s will be equals to 1. And don't forget that n raised to the power of 0 is what? 1. So it means 3 raised to the power of s will be equals to 3 raised to the power of what? 0. So 3 will cancel out 3. S will be equals to 0. So the answer for s is nothing but s is equal to minus 1 or 0. Sorry, I wrote s. Minus 1 or 0. So this is the answer for s. And get what? We are done. Thanks. I remain your vital master, tutor Jero. Thanks.